Question 24, we're given a polynomial function. We're asked to find the x-intercepts and the y-intercepts. And we aren't given a calculator. So I'm going to show you how to do it without a calculator. If you have a handheld calculator, you're more than welcome to use this to graph it, and then you can find those rather quickly. Okay. But we don't have that access to us here, so let's go ahead and see. Y-intercepts will be the quickest, because remember, y-intercepts, those are all points where x equals 0 and y is some value. We'll put b, because usually we use b, but it could be some other letter as well. So 0, some number, that's a y-intercept. X-intercepts, that's where y equals 0 and x is some number. And we'll just put x. I guess maybe over here we could put y. Yeah. So this is going to be a little bit more complicated, but we'll do that second. Take the easy one first. So this one we just go ahead and put a 0 in for each of the x. So we're looking for f of 0. That's a y-intercept. 2 times 0 cubed plus 4 times 0 squared minus 2 times 0. What happens anytime you multiply by 0? This all is going to be 0. So what's our end answer? Negative 4. So if you would have spotted that, yeah, that's going to be our y-intercept. So we'll put that one in there. So that's kind of the one that's designed to not be too difficult to find. The x-intercepts now, that's a little different story. Y is 0, so what we end up doing is we have it set up that this answer is 0 to x to the third plus 4x squared minus 2x minus 4. Now, with linear equations, we would maybe like add 4 to both sides and divide, but with that doesn't work in solving polynomials. So we're going to need to look at some way of maybe factoring this. And it's not quite obvious, you know, with cubics. So let's see. They each could be, I could factor out a 2. Let me put it that way. So take out a 2. What's left? So I took, factor out a 2. So divide out a 2, you get x cubed. Factored out a 2, so there's a 2 left. Factored out a 2, so there's a negative x left. Factored out a 2, so there's a minus 2 in there. So that, and then I could divide both sides by 2, just to kind of not have to worry about this. I can't just drop it, but I can divide both sides by 2. This becomes 1. So now I get 0 equals x cubed, or 1 times everything, right? Plus 2x squared minus x minus 2. Let's see if I can do this, maybe factor by grouping. Yeah, I think that might work. So this these first two, do grouping. I'm going to group these. Maybe what I want to group, I'm just trying to see. So, because I want things to be the same. So if I group these, I could take an x squared out. I have x plus 2, but then there's an x minus 2, so that doesn't help me. Let's group it this way. So let me take this x cubed and this minus x. I'm just reorganizing, right? And then I'm going to group, because that's got the plus there, 2x squared minus 2. Okay, so I'm going to group those guys because there's a common 2. This has a common x. Let's see what happens when we do that. So for the first pair, we're going to group. We're going to factor out the x. So what's left behind? An x squared minus 1. So that's that part. Plus, for this one, what's common? The 2's are common, so let's factor out a 2. And what's left? X squared. Factored out the 2, so 2 divided by 2 is 1. Oh, that looks kind of cool to get these two together. So now factor by grouping. this and this are the same, so I kind of factor that out, x squared minus 1. And then what's left behind? There's an x plus 2 left behind. And again, that's all equal to 0. I hadn't been, should maybe bring that down, right? Because that's what we're working with. Now, before you get too far, you say, okay, that's just before we can do things. This x squared minus 1, that's actually a difference of squares. 1 is 1 squared. So this also factors further into x minus 1, x plus 1. X plus 2 is still there. So now that we've got it factored, and again, that was probably the most challenging part of this question, we can kind of go back to what we did in the previous question as far as finding these zeros, these x-intercepts. So there's going to be three of them. They don't ask for the multiplicity, but they also all have a multiplicity of 1, right? Let's switch here. Okay, so we get x minus 1 equals 0. So these are three things being multiplied. Set them each individually equal to 0. Because, so when x equals positive 1, we put it in there, that gives us a 0. X plus 1 equals 0. Subtract 1 from both sides. Subtract 1. So also add x equals negative 1, we get an x-intercept, a 0. And then x plus 2 equals 0. Subtract 2 from both sides. X equals negative 2. There's our three x-intercepts. So let's come put those in. And again, order does not really matter. I'll put three little things. So we get 1. We get negative 1. But do make sure you get your negatives correct. There we go. So we've got all our x-intercepts. We've got our y-intercept. And we're ready to go. Thank you.